UFC on ESPN Plus One was wild. Cowboy Cerrone's brilliant striking performance and Henry Cejudo's 30-second KO were the highlights for me. But the UFC brass were definitely sweating after the Greg Hardy experiment and the Violence Queen did not shine in the spotlight. On the bright side, we got three bouts that need booking, boys. Numero uno at lightweight, we got number 15 Gregor the Gift Gillespie, undefeated in 13 fights, versus number 5 Motown Phenom Kevin Lee, 10-4 in the UFC. Gillespie thoroughly dominated Yancy Medeiros Saturday night, controlling the entire fight with pressure wrestling and grappling, en route to a second round ground and pound TKO with just a second left on the clock. He's outclassed everyone he's faced on the ground, and now it's about time he took a big jump to face a lightweight with a ground game that rivals him. Kevin Lee is just the man to make an exciting matchup. Fresh off a back-and-forth decision loss to Ally Aquinta, Lee has the wrestling pedigree to possibly force Gillespie away from the takedown and make him stand with him. I'd love to see how Gregor's striking game matches up with the speed and power from Lee on the feet. This bout pits two of the best grapplers at 155 together and might force both to stand and bang. Fight number 2, at bantamweight, Corey Sandhagen, 3-0 in the UFC with 3 finishes, versus number 6, John Hands of Stone Lineker. This fight was originally planned for Saturday night, but Lineker pulled out with an injury. After Sandhagen easily submitted 6-0 Mario Bautista in his place, this original fight makes so much sense to rebook. Although not yet ranked at 135, Corey Sandhagen is a bona fide beast. He's a tricky striker who's almost impossible to finish, as Yuri Alcantara demonstrated to us. He can also take the fight to the ground and end it with his legit jiu-jitsu game. John Lineker's stone hands will test the shifty Sandhagen, and the veteran Brazilian might be able to find some openings in the young prospect's game. I expect Sandhagen will aim to make that big jump in his next bout, and number 6 John Lineker has and will be game to brawl it out. Number 3 at welterweight, Jeff Hands of Steel Neal, 4-0 in the UFC, versus number 11 ranked Neil Magny. Hands of Steel is looking like one of the most polished strikers at 170 after dismantling the tactical veteran Bilal Muhammad last weekend, knocking him down twice to earn the unanimous decision. Jeff Neal has the speed, power, and accuracy to deserve a top 15 opponent, and he needs a dance partner on the feet to show he's ready to contend at the top of the division. Coming off a tough loss to Santiago Ponzinibbio in November, Neil Magny is looking to rebound and has the stand-up game to test Hands of Steel. If you don't give him a top striking talent like Magny, who has 5 UFC KOs, he's gonna keep lining up and knocking down these poor guys on the outside looking in. Those are just 3 bouts that should be booked after UFC on ESPN Plus number 1. Agree or disagree? Let your opinion be known in the comments, and we'll be back with one to watch at UFC on ESPN Plus 2 from Fortaleza, Brasil.